It was a great day in court where we saw Advocate Mngomezulu showing us some quite, you know what I'm saying? He was demonstrating that, you know what, I am an experienced advocate. He did not tell us. He demonstrated that. And I'm saying that for the second time. And then you get the judge was asking that, given that Kelly Khumalo had about 5 to 6 phones, this is after Mngomezulu had asked that, look, Mngomezulu had asked about the 2 phones belonging to Kelly Khumalo, right? Advocate Maloyi raises some objections, telling the court that Kelly Khumalo had about 8 cell phone numbers. Yarr! So it is these cell phone numbers that today Advocate Mngomezulu was arguing to say, actually, this idea that Kelly Khumalo contacted this accused, it is not true. It, in fact, he puts it categorically clear that as far as accused number 1 and accused number 3, they were not even around this situation. They were far away from this situation. That is from at least Advocate Thulane Mngomezulu. He then says, so the judge says, so when you ask this witness about the communication with Kelly Khumalo, it must collaborate with 8 cell phones. Mngomezulu, I differ with that. Judge, it is a common sense. The number 1 state witness. We will talk about the state witness in a separate video. I thought today it is prudent of me to just to talk more about the works of Advocate Mngomezulu, because I was so impressed about how he went about. So we're going to cover some of the few things in this episode. But before we continue in this episode, I put it to you that you do the following. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financial contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, having said that, let's proceed. Okay. Baloyi says he looked at Colonel Lambasasen's evidence and Kelly Khumalo had about 8 cell phones, and we said, okay, we're not gonna bother ourselves that about the 8 cell phone numbers. He says that, and further, it was stated in Gininda's affidavit that Kelly Khumalo had about 4 numbers. That is Advocate Mngomezulu. So you could see that he has gotten the state, and now they are now finding it difficult to escape their own traps, right? Now, but in the affidavit, it noted 4. And then Mngomezulu says, the letter that was written by Captain Mthethwa for Section 205, she lists a number of people in the house, right? The 205 does not look okay. Let's leave this one. We'll come back to this one, right? There's a number that is ending by 338 and the one that is ending by 498. Those are numbers for Kelly Khumalo, and I have an affidavit by Kelly Khumalo to say those numbers, she was using them on the day that Senzo Meiwa was killed, and that's just the background. I put it to you. Then that's where Advocate Mngomezulu is basically saying to the host, these are the numbers that based on Kelly Khumalo's affidavit, she was using these numbers. And if you are saying she was using, if you are saying she communicated with these people, then please tell me, make it make sense to me, because these numbers did not communicate with Kelly Khumalo. Oh, neither Kelly Khumalo communicated with these people. I'm like, there was no communication between Kelly Khumalo and the and accused number three. Specifically on the 26th of October, the state alleges that based on the confession, Kelly Khumalo communicated with the accused, with accused number three, right? Based on the, I don't even have to explain that. But it is self-explanatory that Kelly Khumalo had communicated with these people. And thus, you know what I'm saying? They were able to execute their task on the 26th of October in eradicating Usenzo Meyiwa. And Advocate Mgomezulu is like, listen, that's nonsense. That's bullshit. That doesn't exist. The state says Mgomezulu, he must stay on his lane when he's doing his cross-examination. okay. And I'm like, I was sitting there, I was like, yeah, okay. I'm putting it to you that accused number one and three was not in Fort Lauderdale on the day that Senzo Meyiwa was killed, right? The cell phone shows that he was there, but I cannot tell whether he was there or not. I also cannot have, I also do not have the section 205 of accused number one. Mgomezulu was like, I'm coming gun blazing. We've got evidence based on the very same towers that accused number one and three were not even around that place. Accused number one and three did not know each other on the day that Senzo Meyiwa was killed. Neither was there a communication between them. I can't even comment on that one. And I'm like, yeah. Everybody is wise until they go on a cross-examination. Okay, the letter that was written by Captain Mthethwa. Let me jump this, because I'm trying to make sure that we capture the most important things here. Mgomezulu, the reason I'm asking this brigadier, the investigating officer, did not tell you that there was section 205 that was done in 2014 regarding the people in the house. The relevance on this is based on the communication between accused number three and Kelly Khumalo, which already we know that Mgomezulu is like, listen, that communication never existed. Forget about it. It never existed. Hey! Oh, my daughter. But Mgomezulu, I put it to you as a matter of fact that on the 26th of October 2014, at about 8 past 8 p.m., he was in possession of that device. So whatever you are saying when a host doesn't make sense. Oh, yay, Aibo. We witness Advocate Mgomezulu at his best, bearing the state case. They can see that they don't have a case against the accused. But we know they will continue to do what they've been doing. You know what they have been doing. They are very good at creating a narrative, but never substantiate. They are very good at insinuating, but never provide facts. So I will not be shocked if now they come again with some other shenanigans where they want to be seen like they've been doing this work. You know what I'm saying? I will not be shocked if they will try to introduce some other backdoor evidence to rebut what Mgomezulu has said. But Mgomezulu has done a lot of damage into this case. So let's continue to watch the case. As of me and you guys, we'll see each other in the next episode. But don't forget to like, comment, and share this video. Don't forget to click the notification bell.